وبعد فالإنسان ليس يشرف إلا بما يحفظه ويعرف، لذاك كان حامل القرآن أشرف الأمة أولي الإحسان، وإنهم في الناس أهل الله.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الخلق سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وعنا معهم برحمة رب العالمين. اللهم اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. أما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Again, حياكم الله وبياكم. Forgive us for a later start today. إن شاء الله تعالى it's all بإذن الله عز وجل in the scale of our good deeds إن شاء الله. اللهم آمين. Last week, الحمد لله رب العالمين, we've managed to speak about the rule of إدغام. We spoke, alhamdulillah, now about three rules of the rules of Nun al-Sakinati wa al-Tanween. Which the first was al-Idhharu, and the second was al-Qalbu, and third al-Idgham. And we were speaking last week about al-Idgham. We were rushing a bit at the end, actually. I'm going to do a quick recap, inshallah, azza wa jal, and I will mention, inshallah, for my brothers and sisters, the points that I wanted to mention last week at the end, just in case it wasn't clear, bi-idhnillah. We said al-idgham is to merge the noon sakinah into the letter after. If the letter after the noon sakinah or tanween is one of the six idgham letters, yarmalun, ya, ra, mim, lam, waw, and noon. We've also mentioned that al-idgham is split into two types, and also could be split into three types. Sahih? We said, if we're going to split it in two types, and that's what the majority would do, and that's, I said, recommended for you when you're going to be teaching younger brothers and sisters, or if you want to teach somebody that doesn't want to go, yani he just wants, or she just wants, the basic rules that allow her or him to recite the Quran, inshallah ta'ala, and apply the rules without falling into mistakes. And we said the two types are al-idghamu bi ghunnah or idghamun bi ghunnatin, and the second was idghamun bi ghayri ghunnah. The first was merging with ghunnah, and the second was merging without ghunnah. And we said the letters of idgham bi ghunnah are yanmu, ya, nun, mim, and waw. And the letters of idgham bi ghayri ghunnah were the ra and lam. We said, of course, when you merge into them, you will apply ghunnah in the first type, and the second, you will do it without any ghunnah. So, for example, وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ, yeah, this is what idghamun bi ghunnah. Idghamun bi ghayri ghunnatin, such as وَلَكِنْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Jayid, I'm going quick because, of course, this is a revision of last week. And then we spoke and mentioned that we could also split idgham into three types. Idghamun bi ghunnatin kamil, وإدغام بغنة ناقص، وإدغام بغنة، وإدغام بغير غنة كامل. جيد. And we said for the إدغام بغنة كامل, there are two letters in this type or category, and those two letters are the ميم and نون. And we said when you merge into the ميم or into the نون متحركة, that's after the نون ساكن or تنوين, it is a إدغام بغنة, and it is كامل due to the existence as well as the attribute of the first noon sakina disappearing. Yeah. So, for example, when I say وَمَنْ نُعَمِّرْهُ وَمَنْ نُعَمِّرْهُ وَمَنْ, this noon that you hear is the second noon, and the ghunna you hear is the attribute of the second noon, not the first one. So this is why it's kamil. And we define kamil or complete merging, and we said that it is what? Merging where both the existence and attribute of the first letter disappear. And we said complete and incomplete merging is applied to all types of idgham, not only the idgham that of the noon sakinah and tanween. Akhi, I think you wasn't here last week, no? So if you feel a bit shaky in what I'm going to be speaking about now, try inshallah ta'ala go back. Of course, this is for Akhi Abdul Rahman Muhammad, and for any of the other brothers and sisters that were not here last week, try and watch, inshallah ta'ala, the video that Akhi Abdul Samad has uploaded. جيد. We said it is applied with all types of idgham, not only the idgham of nun sakinati wa tanween. And as idgham bighunnat al-naqs, when we say for example miwal, and the letters for this are waw and ya. When I say miwal, now the nun, the existence of the nun has disappeared, but there is a ghunna that you hear. You cannot say this ghunna is what the attribute of the next letter, which is the waw, because waw does not have ghunna as an attribute. Therefore, this ghunna that we hear is the attribute of the nun sakina, or the nun sakina that's hidden in the tanween that has traveled with us on to the next letter. And lastly, we spoke about idghamun bighayri ghunnatin kamil. And we said this, the letters here are the ra and lam. When you say mir rabbik, yakullahu, walam yakullahu, hakada. These, of course, there is no ghunna. And it is kamil due to the existence as well as the attribute of the noon disappearing. The attribute of the noon here that we're talking about is what? Ghunna. Jayid. And we said, yeah, we mentioned this one. And we've mentioned this. Okay, we said there are a few things we must know about al-idgham. And we said idgham cannot happen within what? One word. We said, of course, in idhar and qalb, that idgham can idhar and qalb can occur within one word, and it could also come between two separate words. Whereas idgham can only happen between two separate words. However, there are some exceptions in the Quran where you see an idgham happening within one word, not an idgham happening, an idgham condition happening within one word or occurring within one word, but we do not do idgham. Yes? And how many of those words are in the Quran? Four. Sahih? Jayid. Jazakum Allahu khayran. So these four words are what? Dunya, and it comes in different forms. Ad-dunya, wa hakada, and it will come many times in the Quran. Sinwan, qinwan, bunyan. If you look at all of those four words, you will find out that what? That there is a condition of idgham within the word. So you'll have a nun sakina and after it one of the idgham letters. But you will not do idgham. What will you do? Idhar. And what is this idhar called? Shadh. Yeah, with the tongue out. Shadh. Idharun shadh. Or idharun mutlaq. Yes, mutlaq. Absolute idhar or odd idhar. When you say absolute idhar, it might not be so easy to understand, but you, of course, now know. When you say odd idhar, you know that as something odd, and you do not normally do idhar in that situation. Jayid. We also mentioned at the end of the halaqa last week that there are three other places in the Quran where you will have what? A condition of idgham between two separate words, but there is an exception and you will do odd idhar again. And we said two of them, the first ones I've wrote it actually because I didn't have it on the slides, even though you didn't see them last week, and I've sent it to Akhi Naeem. So if you all should have received an email, inshallah ta'ala, if your email is with the brothers, you should inshallah ta'ala receive it and you can be on the same page as I am now. We've mentioned al-idhharu al-shadhu or al-idhharu al-mutlaq. There are some other rules that fall under it, but the condition of the idgham is between two separate words. Yeah? So I have here written, there are also examples that occur with the condition of idgham between two separate words in which we will also not merge. There are three examples of this in the Quran which fall under the following ruling. Now I've put this here, that there are three of these rules that fall under the same ruling. However, there are two actually. The last one, yes, it is idhar shadh, but it falls under a different ruling. I'm going to speak about that when I get to it, inshallah ta'ala. So you could add that as a note and add it to the slides if you want, inshallah ta'ala. These slides, they could be my gift to you, inshallah azawajal. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept it from us and to, inshallah ta'ala, forgive us if there is anything wrong in it and increase us in knowledge and to make, inshallah, a cause for us all to enter Jannah and the highest levels of Jannah. Allahumma ameen. Jayid. Now don't go put copyright and say this is yours. هذا علم إن شاء الله صدقة جارية نسأل الله أن يتقبل. جيد. So the first example is in Surah Yasin. When we say Yasin in the Quran, it's written Yasin joined together. So there is no noon sakinah that's written there. صح ولا لا? Yes or no? Yes. However, when I pronounce it, what do I say? Yasin. What's that? Noon sakinah. صح ولا لا? If I want to join it with the next ayah, do I say Yasin wal Qur'an al Hakim? Do I do this? In the way of Shatibiyya, you don't. However, in Tayyibah, there are some ways that you will what? You will do this merging. So now if you go and put on YouTube Sheikh Al-Manshawi reciting Surah Yasin or Surah Noon, you might hear merging. You might hear him reciting saying Yasin wal Qur'an. Lakin, do you say this is wrong? La, this is a different way. We are following the way of Shatibiyya, inshallah ta'ala. And بإذن الله, we ask Allah to increase us in knowledge and to give us the ability to study, of course, طيبة النشر. اللهم أمين. جيد. So, ياسين والقرآن الحكيم. So I done what? إظهار. Was this a normal type of إظهار يا أخواني وأخواتي? No, it's إظهار شاذ. جميل. سورة القلم أيضا. When we recite, we say بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نون والقلم وما يسطرون. Did I merge? I did what? إظهار. And was this a normal type of إظهار again? No, this was إظهار شاذ. Where is the third example? Have you received the email, brothers and sisters, or not? Yeah? Okay. بعثوهم ولا ما بعثوه? Have you received the إخواني وأخواتي? No? Yes? You got it. So if you haven't got it, that means you might not have your email with the brothers? You don't? Jameel, was you here last week? الله غفر الله لك ما اسمك يا أخي أبو بكر you did the test صح yeah okay remind me inshallah to give you the papers before we leave بإذن الله brothers and sisters جيد you don't have you didn't receive it جيد so brothers inshallah تعالى if you could leave your emails with because نعيم's left من يأخذ الإيميلات هذه Okay. خلاص. يوسف؟ Yes, he mentioned me. أستر على الأخ. لعله لا يريد أن يخبر أحد. info@readandassend.co.uk Email the... Okay, the email is on the banner, brothers and sisters there. So inshallah, you could email and you will be speaking to brother Naeem and he will add your emails bi-idhnillah. Okay? Because last week I mentioned to put your email, you forgot maybe. La bas. Jayid, the third example, ya akhawani wa akhawati, if you do have the slides, please share with the brothers and sisters that do not have it. Is in Surah Al-Qiyamah, verse 27. Yes, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وقيل من راق yes من راق what is this ruling here نون ساكنة after the letter ra what do we normally do we do merging with no غنة إدغام بغير غنة كامل جزاك الله خيرا يا يوسف so we will recite it and normally we say وقيل من راق نعم and in some قراءات you recite like this ولكن in حفص من طريق الشاطبية we do what here what do we do sect yeah you say it sect there is a همس on the calf and a همس on the تاء السكت or a sect this ruling or sect means if you tell a kid اسكت it means to him يعني pause be quiet خلاص لا تتكلم in Arabic language In the science of Quran, when you say sect, it means, or the definition of a sect, we're going to speak about this in the future, inshallah. A sect is a pause that you are, it's a pause on a letter where you hold your breath and then continue. So when you recite Surah Al-Qiyamah, you should say وَقِيلَ مَنْ رَاقَ. Yeah, a pause without taking a breath. You do not take a breath and saying وَقِيلَ مَنْ رَاقَ. You shouldn't do that. You just do a sect. جيد. So this rule here in Surah Al-Qiyamah, verse 27, it is an idhar shad. Yes. However, it falls under the ruling of sect more than it falls under the ruling of idhar, even though you will be doing idhar. So you could keep it under idhar shad if you like, but leave it as I have wrote, I put in Surah Al-Qiyamah, ayah number 27, where we will apply the rule of sect. Yeah, so that's where it occurs again, where we do idhar shad. And I explained what sect is a pause on the noon without taking a breath in this case. And in Hafs an Asim, from the way of Shatibiyya, we have six sectas in the Quran that we will be learning about in the future, inshallah ta'ala. Jayid. Any questions, brothers and sisters? No questions? Jameel. Moving on. Tafaddal. Because I am pronouncing the noon clearly. I am not merging it. Yeah? If you pronounce the noon clearly, what does that mean? Idhar. Sahih ala? Is it clear? So you are showing the noon clearly, therefore you're falling under, you anta tudhirun noon, or tudhirin noon. Yeah? You are showing the noon clearly. Therefore it is falling under idhar. But of course it's not the normal type of idhar, or not the normal condition of idhar. Jameel, let's move on inshallah ta'ala to our fourth and final rule of the rules of noon, sakin, and tanin. I'm hoping inshallah azza wa jal, with of course your help and the inshallah ta'ala alert and awake faces bi idhnillah, I'm hoping to finish this rule today as well as the rules of Mim Sakina. Yes, if we can. And this means if we do that, next week we will start on the interesting topic, which is what? Of course, all these rules are interesting. Walakin we will start on Al-Mudud. Jazakallah khair. Jameel. So Al-Ikhfa is the fourth and final rule that we're going to be speaking about when it comes to what? The rules of Nun Sakinati and Tanween. Al-Ikhfa is to hide something. If I tell Akhi Habib, Akhfi Qalamak, it means to hide your pen. Yes? And in the science of Quran, when we say Ikhfa, what does it mean, my brothers and sisters? We're going back again to what? The heading, Nun Sakina, or the Nun Sakina that's hidden in the Tanween. Jameel, why am I saying the Nun Sakina that's hidden in the Tanween? Because you are actually pronouncing a Nun Sakina. Yes? We always say the Nun Sakina or Tanween, but it's a Nun Sakina or Nun Sakina that's hidden in the Tanween. Jameel, just to be precise, inshallah. So Al-Ikhfa is to hide. In the science of Quran, it is to hide the Nun Sakina or Tanween and replace it with Ghunna when any of the 15 Ikhfa letters appear after the Nun Sakina or Tanween. Is that clear? And we have the 15 Ikhfa letters. Yes? They are in the poem of Al-Jazriya, or Tuhfat Al-Atfar, sorry. صف ذاتنا كم جاد شخص قد سما. The beginning, the first letters of each word. If you know the تحفة الأطفال, it's good to remember like this. Yeah, just like when we spoke about the إظهار, we said أخي هاك علما حازه غير خاسري. جيد. So a note again here we have about إخفاء that you must put in mind. By the way, I'm speaking fast because I forgot some brothers. Oh, I assumed everyone has the slides in front of them. So I will repeat. If you do, brothers and sisters, have a phone or laptop or anything that you, and you have the slides on it, sit next to somebody that does not have it, inshallah, so that you could get the ajr. And inshallah, you could save us a bit more time, inshallah, from repeating. Jayid. So again, I will define al-ikhfa. Al-ikhfa is to hide the noon sakina, or the Nun Sakina that's hidden in the Tanween, and replace it with a Ghunna if any of the 15 Ikhfa letters appear after Nun Sakina or Tanween. Is that clear? Shall I repeat one more time? Yes. Al-Ikhfa is to hide the Nun Sakina or the Nun Sakina that's hidden in the Tanween if any of the 15, and replace it with Ghunna if any of the 15 Ikhfa letters appear after the Noon, Sakina, or Tanween. Jameel, note, Ikhfa can happen between two separate words as well as within what? One word. It could appear between two separate words or within one word. So the only odd rule we had was what? not idgham. No, you're right, but not idgham. Idgham. I mentioned last week, a lot of people say idgham. I don't know why, but try, it's a dal, yeah? I think because you read it in transliteration, you see? Oh, okay. Jameel, labas. Oh, but a lot of brothers and sisters, they say idgham instead of idgham. There's a qalqala and it's a dal. Jameel. Al-idgham was the only odd rule where we what? Between two separate words. Jazakallahu khayran, akhi Bilal. Jameel. So we have examples here. If you don't have them in front of you, look, inshallah. For example, we have within one word, kuntum, kuntum, a noon sakin, and after it, a ta. Yes? You remove the noon and you put in its place a ghunnah and you get ready to say the ta. Kuntum. Jameel. Let's skip these examples, my brothers and sisters, and go to the next slide where we're going to understand how do we apply this ghunnah of ikhfa. Yes? And a bit more. And then we will speak about the levels of ikhfa. And then come back to those examples on the first slide of ikhfa. Is that clear? Jameel. I put it on the first slide because I didn't have space and I didn't want to put a new slide just for the examples. Jameel, just to make it look a bit better, even though it doesn't look the best, ولكن, alhamdulillah. How do we apply the ghunnah of ikhfa, my brothers and sisters? And this is very, very important. Because a lot of us actually fall into the mistake when applying a ghunnah of ikhfa. We either go so close to the letter preceding the nun sakin or tanween and end up touching it or doing like idgham, or we end up giving a noon, and that's the most or the biggest mistake is to say a noon in this ghunnah instead of what giving a ghunnah, they touch the noon. And I'm gonna explain all the weaknesses and why and how to avoid them, inshallah ta'ala. So how do we apply the ghunnah of ikhfa? Let me read and then explain, inshallah. So the ghunnah must be related to the next letter that appears after the noon sakina or tanween. If the next letter is a full mouth letter, then the ghunnah must be full mouth or heavy. Yes? If the next letter after the noon sakina or tanween is a empty mouth or light letter, my ghunnah must be light or empty mouth. And this is where a lot of subhanAllah reciters will fall into mistake. And a professional reciter must let the listener know that of the letter that's coming before it comes. For example, when I say Mil, what's the letter that's coming? Qaf. Sah? If you say Milqa, did you expect a qaf? No. You expected mumkin a sin. Mils. Yeah? So when you are applying the ghunnah of ikhfa, my brothers and sisters, it's important if you want to, inshallah ta'ala, do it with a high level of professionalism, inshallah, to go as close. So I want you to write this note because I don't think I've wrote it in the notes. So another note said the reciter must try and place the organ as close as possible. Actually, I did write it. So the way to apply the ghunna here, or to show the listener what letters coming next after the ghunna, what you need to do is that the reciter must try and place their organ as close as possible to the next letter that appears after the noon sakina or tanween without touching the next letter and neither touching the noon sakina. And this is going to be a bit difficult to understand without going on to the levels of ikhfa. Yeah? And that's the last slide of what? Ikhfa. Which is the levels of ikhfa. Jayid. So again, the ghunnah must be related to the next letter. If the next letter is heavy, the ghunnah is heavy. If the next letter is light, the ghunnah is light. So you cannot say sal, sal. Yeah, you can't say sal, sal. This is not professional. Of course, you didn't touch the sad and you didn't touch the noon, but your ghunnah did not allow the listener to say, ah, the sad is coming. The correct one is what? Min salsal. Jameel? جيد. And also we said, you must bring your organ as close as possible to the next letter without touching the next letter and neither touching what? The noon. You might be like, what has the noon got to do with it? I'm hiding it. Now you'll find out, inshallah ta'ala. Let's go to the slide of the levels of ikhfa. Yes? There are different levels of ikhfa with regards to the strength or effort of in hiding. Yes? So, the first level is aqwa martaba, or al martaba. Yeah, the strongest level of hiding, aqwa martaba. And this is the level where we are required to put the most effort in hiding the noon sakina, or the noon sakina that's hidden in the tanween. Why is that? You will look, and by the way, these three levels, the 15 letters of ikhfa are split and put into each level. So as you see, hopefully if you have the slides in front of you, inshallah, the first level, which is the strongest level of hiding, has what? Three letters. Jazakallahu khairan. Walaikum salam tukatu. Those three letters are what? At-ta'u, wa-dalu, wa-ta'. Now, if you know from previously, please don't say it. I want the brothers and sisters that haven't done it before, with myself maybe, just, if you know, if you've studied it, don't say it, afdal. Let allow the brothers and sisters that haven't studied it before, look here at the letters and think of the makharij of letters and the attributes of letters and decide, why are those three letters, when they appear after noon sakin or tanween, why do I put the most effort in hiding the noon? So it is going to be, I'll give you a clue now inshallah, it is going to be something to do with what? The makharij of the tal, dal, ta, and the relation of the makharij of those three letters, and the relation of the makhraj to the makhraj of the noon. Huh? It is something to do with the makharij. We haven't wrote it before, but if you think of makharij, and if you think, when I do ghunna, and I've mentioned earlier, a note in the previous slide, it says, try and place your organ as close as possible to the next letter, to the ta, dal, and ta, without touching the ta, dal, and ta, and neither touching the noon. So why am I required to put the most effort in hiding in this section? And if you have the slides, actually it says the reason there. Well, I can try and not look at it. Yeah. And just another thing that may help you answer, if you haven't already seen the answer, is that in this level of ikhfa, my tongue would be furthest away from the next letter. Huh? Does anyone know, or shall we save time and I say it? In the makhraj. Jazakallahu khairan ya ukhti. Did you read it, or you done it yourself? MashaAllah, ahsanti, barakallahu feek. So when you look, alhamdulillah, and you relate things together, you become the teacher of your own, MashaAllah. Ahsanti. Jazakallahu khairan wa barakallahu feek. So the ta, dal, and ta, the makhraj of those three letters, is very close to the makhraj of what? Noon. So when I'm applying ghunna, my brothers and sisters, my tongue is supposed to go as close as possible to the next letter. So this is my upper palate, the upper palate of my mouth, brothers and sisters. If you look here, inshallah, this is the upper palate of my mouth, and this is my tongue, yeah? And this is the exit of the mouth. So the ta, dal, and ta are all here. The noon is just before it. So I need to go as close as possible to the ta, dal, and ta without touching them and neither touching the noon. So without touching them, you understand. How would I touch the noon? I'm hiding it. How would you touch it? The answer is, you are giving what? Ghunna. صح ولا لا? When you're giving ghunna, the noon is like, the makhraj of the noon is going to become like a magnet. Because you're giving ghunna so close to its makhraj, it's going to tell the tongue, come here. This, yeah? My makhraj is here, and you're giving my attribute. You cannot give it elsewhere. Of course it doesn't do that, but يعني, if you understand like that, easier. Jayid. So, when you're going to the ta, dal, ta, if you go too close, no matter how professional you are, you're going to touch the noon. Why? Unless you don't give ghunna. Kuttum. If you give ghunna and you go too close to the ta, you will end up touching the noon because of the closeness between the makhraj of the noon and the makhraj of the ta, dal, and ta. Jayid. So you should say, كنت. Now some people they exaggerate too much and they say كنت and they go so far away from the letter and it's like adding an ألف. أو كنتم لا. Go as close as possible to the next letter without touching it and neither touching what? The نون. Yes? And you'll hear قراء to make it easier for themselves. They go onto the makhraj. They give the ghunna on the makhraj. Saying, كنتم. I now was in my, I wanted to touch the makhraj of the ta. And I touched the makhraj and I was doing the ghunna on the makhraj of the ta. But the noon was like a magnet and my tongue touched the noon. So what did I do? Idhar. And this is wrong. Is that clear, my brothers and sisters? And this is actually the least easy level of ikhfa to apply. When you have a dal, ta, or ta after noon sakina, this is the majority or the most common mistake where people fall into, and they will be giving ghunna on a noon instead of giving ghunna in an empty space. Yes? And trying to show the listener that this is the letter that's coming. So, min, dal. Yes? Min duni kuntum. It's the same here, the ta and dal. If you know the Arabic language and you know the word, you'll spot straight away. It's either dal or ta. But now the third letter, min tay. You know that it's a ta. Why? Firstly, you could hear how close my tongue. If you studied makharij and if you think and imagine how your mouth is inside, you will know, this reciter's tongue is going to wear the makharij of the ta, dal and ta. But it's giving a heavy ghunna. It's a ta. Hakada. Min tayyibat. And if you don't be careful, you will end up touching the noon. Yeah? Meow. There is a gap. Meow. If I open my mouth, there will be a gap, but of course, do not open your mouth. So the reason for this is that the articulation point of the letters in this level is very close to the articulation point of the letter noon. Does everyone understand this level or not? Yes? Jameel. So what do you not understand? Or ask me something that I could explain. What do you not understand in it? Okay, Jameel. La ba's. It's very important that, or it's very helpful, inshallah, if you could have the slides with you. So now, bi'idhnillah, hopefully, today actually, the rules of Meem Sakina, akhwani wa akhawati, you probably received it when you was in Abu Abdullah Yunus' lesson, because I finished them actually quite late. So for those that don't have a phone or laptop, forgive me, that you could have printed them if I sent them earlier. Otherwise, inshallah, try and share with your neighbors if we have time to get to the noon, to the rules of Meem Sakin, inshallah. But for Akhi Muhammad, what is it that's not clear? Do you understand the ikhfa and when do we hide? Was you with us when we done idhar and iqlab? Or qalb? When was it? Last week? No. No, not the week before. Like a month before. Nah. So not last week, a month before that. Jameel, okay. So what I want from you, inshallah ta'ala, is try and watch the videos. If you do not understand it by next week, the videos are there, inshallah. Jazakallah khair, akhi Abdullah. Try, watch it. And take a note. If you don't understand, ask me inshallah ta'ala and I'm more than happy to explain it. Exactly. Because if you don't revise, my brothers and sisters, you're going to forget the cycle of how it's going. You're always talking about noon sakin, hiding, merging, showing clearly, or changing what? The noon sakin and tanween. So if you forget that, then you wouldn't know what's ikhfa. Why am I hiding? Why do I need to hide? You understand? So try inshallah ta'ala. And next week, I'm hoping to see you. And if you don't understand, I'm hoping that I will know, inshallah ta'ala. Whether it's yourself or any of the sisters or any of the remaining brothers, even though the brothers, mashallah, the numbers are decreasing week by week. May Allah forgive us and guide us and give us the ability to recite Surah Al-Fatiha correctly in the Salah. Some of it, خلاص لا بأس. Let's go to the second level of ikhfa, inshallah. So just a quick recap of ikhfa and the first level, inshallah. We said al-ikhfa is to hide the noon sakina or tanween and replace it with a ghunna. if any of the 15 ikhfa letters come after noon sakin or tanween. Yeah? For example, when I say قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقَ مِن شَرِّ مَا خَلَقَ. Yeah, the second ayah, you hear a qari saying مِن شَرِّ. What's this غُنَّة? Why did I do this غُنَّة? There is a noon sakinah. I didn't pronounce it. I put up غُنَّة in its place. And after is the letter sheen. And this letter sheen is a letter of ikhfa. Therefore, ikhfa means to hide. I must hide this noon sakinah and replace it with a غُنَّة and go as close as possible to the sheen without touching the sheen and neither touching the noon. Yes? Is that clear? جيد. Going to the next level, and we said that ta, dal, and ta were the strongest level of hiding, because when the ta, dal, ta come after noon, sakin, or tanween, and you hide the noon and give a ghunna, if you go too close to the dal, ta, or ta, you will end up touching the noon. And the reason for this is because the makhraj, the articulation point of the ta, dal, and ta, is very close to the makhraj of the noon. Therefore, you need to go a bit further. So there is more effort required in this level of hiding. Going to the next level, المرتبة الوسطى أو أوسط مرتبة. This is the moderate level of hiding. So I need to, of course, put effort, but as not as much as what? The first level. And there are 10 letters in this level, which are what? The ثاء, جيم, ذال, زاي, سين, شين, صاد, ضاد, ضاء, and فاء. Is that clear? So I'm going to skip this level for a second and go to the last level, and then we will come back to the second one, so that it could be a bit easier for you this way, inshallah. The last martabah, which is the al-martabah al-dunya or adana martabah, which is the weakest level of hiding. What do I mean by the weakest level of hiding? This means that you will need to put no extra effort, or it's the weakest, yani there's no effort needed in hiding. It's the easiest one to apply, and actually you will find reciters falling into a aib, a weakness here, where they do not apply this one correctly. So the letters of this level are the qaf and kaf. Yes? So the qaf and kaf, now remember what we were speaking about, the first level and the closeness of the makharij of the noon and the delta and ta and so on and so forth. Look at the qaf and kaf. Think about the makharij of qaf and kaf and relate it to the makhraj of the noon, and think of the first level and what we said there. What do you think? They are the furthest apart. The makhraj of the noon sakina is far from the makhraj of the qaf and kaf. Where is the makhraj of qaf and kaf? Back of the tongue. Where is the makhraj of the noon? The tip. Are they close or far? Far. So if I do my ghunna on the articulation point of the qaf or kaf, will the noon act like a magnet and take the tongue? No, it's impossible. You can't go, yeah, this is the tongue here, you can't do this. Yeah, your ghunna is going to be on the makhraj of the qaf or kaf. And this is where you'll find some reciters, what they do here, they apply what they should apply on the first level. They say, for example, إِن كُنتُم. Did you think I was going to say kaf? No. If I say ink, ink, just like the ink in English, hakada, this is how it's applied. Do you say ink in English? No, you say ink, but give ghunna with it. Ink, hakada, walakin akmal, طبعا. Ink, kuntum. In this, or in these two words, I had two levels of ikhfa, the weakest and the strongest. The first one, ink, was the weakest level of ikhfa, where I did not need to put any extra effort in hiding. I gave my ghunna on the makhraj of the kaf. Why? Because I'm not afraid that if I give the ghunna on the makhraj of the kaf, I will end up touching what? The noon. Is that clear? So I will say ink, but that doesn't mean you touch, you say the actual kaf. You don't say ink, 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 ink. You're not going to do this. In kuntum. Do you notice there was no gap in ink? Yes or no? There was no gap in my mouth between my tongue and the upper palate. Ink. Is there a gap? No. Kuntum. Is there a gap? Yes. Someone said la. Okay, good. So again, ink. Is there a gap? Kuntum. Is there a gap? Yes. وَهَكَذَا إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى تُقْرَأْ. You must go and give the ghunna on the makhraj of the kaf. Same thing with the qaf. You don't say من قبل. There is a gap there. You don't do this. You must give the غنة on the مخرج of the قاف. Of course, this is not a لحن جلي. This is لحن خفي and even more hidden. Yeah, it's even more hidden. And some people actually they study and they study it and allow it. They be like, خلاص, there's no levels. إخفاء إخفاء is all one. Like to be more professional, you need to يعني make the listener know of the letter that's coming. ميوق. Look, my غنة وزن دقاف. ميوق. ميوقابل. هكذا انشرت. Is that clear, my brothers and sisters? Now, without me explaining, the moderate level of hiding has become clear. The moderate level of hiding, I won't be as far away from the next letter as I was with the first level, and neither would I be as close to the next letter as I will be with what? The weakest level. Is that clear? So, for example, with the sheen in Surah Al-Falaq, as we recited, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق من شر. I went a bit closer to the sheen, if you notice, than when I had كنت. My tongue was further away from the مخرج of the تاء than it was when I did the إخفاء into with the sheen. With the sheen, I got a bit closer to the sheen. I got a bit braver. Because I thought, the sheen is not as close to the makhraj of the noon as the ta' dal and ta'a. Yes? So you say, min shadri, min sh. Same thing with the sheen. Min sulalah. And with the others, all the same, inshallah ta'ala. Look at my tongue. Min tha. I'm very close coming to the tha. When my ghunna is finished, I say the tha. But I'm not on the tha if I say min. What can you hear? Noon. Because I touched the tha. Or I did the ghunna on the makhraj like the qaf and ka. And I don't go so far. Min thamara. This is like I was going to say ta dal or ta. Or ta dal. Yes? Is that clear, my brothers and sisters, or not? Yes or no? No or yes? Jayid. Move on? Sorry. Yes. I said in the notes, go as close as possible to the ta, dal, or ta, or any other letter of ikhfa without touching the noon and neither touching the next letter. Except for the last level, due to it being very far from what? The makhraj of the noon, which is the qaf and kaf, you will give the ghunna on the makhraj. Yes? So now when I say stay away from the ta, dal, and ta, you don't put your tongue straight far behind and you say, you lay it down, saying, min dunih la. You go, min. You see where my tongue is? It's going as close as possible to the dal without touching it. Now, if you're a beginner, my brothers and sisters, you won't be able to go maybe as close as I did. Or maybe other reciters will go even closer than I can without touching the noon. Why? It's about the practice of recitation. Na'am? Because the tongue, subhanAllah, is a muscle. Just like as you go gym to become fit or to train a certain muscle in your body, the best exercise for the tongue is the recitation of the Quran. And when one recites the Quran a lot, subhanAllah, the control they have of their tongue is beyond anything else, subhanAllah. Even the brothers and sisters, sometimes they complain, or they say, I have a lisp or anything. The Quran is what, subhanAllah, cures this habit. Yeah? Jayid. Are there any other questions, Yusuf, or any of the brothers and sisters? Questions? Yes or no? Jameel. Let's go back to the two slides before, which is the examples. I've given you here some examples at the bottom. Some examples of ikhfa within one word and some examples of ikhfa within two words. Look at them and ask me any questions if there are any. So the first one, kuntum. What level of hiding is that? One, two, or three? One. The second example, min qabl. Wa alaykum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Min qabl. Is it the first, second, or third level of ikhfa? Third, last one. The weakest level of hiding, because the makhraj of the qaf is very far from the makhraj of the noon, and I am not afraid that the noon is going to take my tongue. أنفسكم. Number two, جزاك الله خيرا, which is the moderate level of hiding. من طين. The first, جزاك الله خيرا. الإنسان. Second and the last, من تراب. The first level of hiding. Are there any questions, my brothers and sisters? Yes or no? No? جميل. We have finished the rules of نون الساكنة والتنوين بحمد الله وفضله علينا. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يتقبل هذا العلم منا وأن يجعله في ميزان حسناتنا ويجعله شفيع لنا أو شفيعا لنا يا رب العالمين. جيد. Shall we start? It is 9:29. Shall we start on the rules of ميم ساكن or not? Abdul Samad, what do you think? You're smiling. جميل. I like to put you on the spot. Shall we continue or shall we stop here? The rules of ميم ساكنة, by the way, brothers and sisters, is very easy. And I think, unless of course it takes us longer, I think in 15 minutes it would be done. Shall we continue or shall we stop? No, it's not up to me, it's up to the brothers and sisters. Mainly the sisters, not of course putting one over the other. ولكن أخوات, it's a bit more dangerous for them to go home late. So أخواتي, shall we continue? That's one sister. Someone said no, I think. Huh? I know you will want to do it, Akhi Yusuf. If we stay until Fajr, you wouldn't say no. MashaAllah. So if one of the sisters can, just ask the sisters, inshallah, and we will continue from there. Huh? And la ilaha illallah. And the brother just could take a breath before we continue. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا. It's only three rules, by the way. الأحكام ميم ساكنتي are three rules. I don't mind, and I'm happy to continue, and I'm happy to leave it till next week. Yeah, it's totally up to my brothers and sisters. We continue. جيد إن شاء الله. So check your emails, because you've received the rules of ميم ساكنة in the lesson of أخي شيخ أبو عبد الله يونس. أحكام الميم الساكنة أحكام الميم الساكنة not أحكام الميم الساكنة والتنوين. The rules of ميم ساكنة is in the same way as the rules of نون ساكنة. So when we're talking about, there are three rules actually, brothers and sisters, that fall under this section. We know them as الإخفاء الشفوي والإدغام الشفوي والإظهار الشفوي. الإدغام, why, what does الشفوي mean? Where does الشفوي come from or originate from? The lips. Yes, جزاك الله خيرا. So الشفوي comes from what? The two lips, or the شفة, the lips. So we know it's to do with the lips. Why? Because the ميم ساكنة comes from where? Or the meme anyway comes from where? Lips, meme. And why do we add shafawi? To differentiate it between, or to differentiate between the rules of meme sakina and the rules of nun sakina. I do not know if I mentioned to you, brothers and sisters, I might have mentioned it a month ago when we started the rules of nun and sakina. We said that al-idhar is also known as al-idhar al-what? Al-halqi. جزاك الله خيرا. Al-halqi, the throat idhar. To differentiate it with what? إظهار شفوي. إخفاء is also known as الإخفاء. الإخفاء. No, no, the النون ساكنة one. الإخفاء الحقيقي. Yes. The real إخفاء. And الإدغام. And then we have القلب, of course, is only one rule anyway. الإدغام الحقيقي, and then the القلب is only one rule, or الإقلاب. جميل. So number one is الإدغام الشفوي, which is also known as إدغام المثلين. You will see in books, sometimes they will write it as إدغام المثلين, or إدغام المتماثلين. Yes? So it's al-idgham al-shafawi is known as idgham al-mithlaini or idgham al-mutamathilain. What does al-mithlaini or al-mutamathil, also known as al-idgham al-mutamathil or idgham al-mutamathilain? What does al-mutamathil wal-mutamathilaini or al-mithlain? It's all the same meaning. What is it? Huh? Same letter. Yes? So al-idgham al-mutamathil or idgham al-mithlaini or al-mutamathilain is the idgham, the merging of the identical letters. Yes? But in this section rule, we want to call it what? Idgham shafawi, so that we could stay in the same pattern, because ikhfa shafawi, and then we have idhar shafawi. Is that clear? In the introduction, in the first slide, I've put al-idgham al-shafawi, al-ikhfa al-shafawi, then al-idhar al-shafawi. However, I'm going to speak about al-ikhfa al-shafawi, you awwalan, the first. Yes? What is al-ikhfa, brothers and sisters, professionals? What is it? To hide. To hide what? Meem sakina. Before it was hiding what? Noon sakina. Now we're talking about a different heading, which is meem sakina. When I say hide or merge or show, we're talking about what? Meem sakina. So al-ikhfa al-shafawiyu, this rule is where we hide the meem sakina or change it from a pure meem to an impure or hidden meem if the letter ba precedes it. So if the letter ba comes after the meem sakina, if the letter ba comes after the meem sakina, then I will hide this meem and replace it, or sorry, change it to what? An impure or hidden meme, and I will give what? Ghunna with this hiding. So I have in another line, it says, this hiding will require you to apply the third level of ghunna. Now I didn't have to put this. And the books, of course, they're not going to put you, tell you in the third level of ghunna. This is between you, me and you, my brothers and sisters. Yes? Which is, what's the third level of ghunna? The ghunna of ikhfa, the ghunna of qalb, the ghunna of ikhfa shafawi. If you remember when we spoke about the levels of ghunna, if you go back to the slides of ikhfa, of ghunna, we had five levels. The first level of the noon wa meem mushaddadatain. The second is the idgham bi ghunna naqis, waw and ya. Yes. Yeah. Sah wala la? Yes. And the third level is what? Al-ikhfa and al-ikhfa al-shafawi and al-qalb. And the fourth is the noon wa meem sakinatain with a sukoon. And the fifth is the noon or meem al-mutaharrikatain. Yes, there is a bit more actually on the second level when you say, and the first level actually. For example, when you have idgham shamsi, yeah, into the noon or into the meem, yeah. When you say قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ, this is you merged into the noon, and this is called idgham shamsi, sun merging. Why sun? Sun letters, because you don't say al-nas, you say an-nas. This is not our topic though. Yes? We will hopefully be speaking about this. Actually, I forgot, yes. I will be speaking about this before the mudud. Yes? Even though we will be speaking about it in depth and in a more professional way in the future, but it's important that we know it for now, just as a basic way, in a certain way, study it. And then move on to mudud, and then we speak about the more professional rules where we will be covering a lot of these rules, like the lam sakina rules that I'm going to be speaking about bi-idhnillah next week. Yeah? Why? Just so that when you recite, you're reciting correctly and you know what rule is to be applied. So al-ikhfa al-shafawiyu is to hide the meem sakina and or change it from a pure meem into an impure or hidden meem, giving ghunna from which level? Giving ghunna of the third level, yeah, or applying the third level of ghunna. Somebody might say, but this is not hiding. It's not hiding if you compare it to what? The hiding of noon sakina. The noon sakina is completely hidden. This one is not completely hidden. It is taken, some of its rights has been what? Taken. You have not given a full pure meem. Yes? How do we apply it? And before this, the rule of ikhfa shafawi can only happen what? Between two separate words. You can never have a ميم ساكنة and a باء متحركة after it within one word. So الإخفاء الشفوي can only occur or happen between two separate words and can never occur or happen within one word. Is that clear? جيد. So how do I do this rule? How do I apply this غنة? And how do I change or make a or differentiate between a pure and an impure meme? Now the ulama have two opinions. The first opinion we're going to speak about is that they say أن تترك فرجة بين شفتيك, to keep a small gap between your two lips. And they go further and they say where you will fit a piece of paper, like an A4 paper, between your lips. And I think we've spoken about this when we spoke about قلب and إقلاب. Yes, because it's the same thing here, or very similar. They said you keep a furja. What's a furja? A little gap between your lips. So you'll say, in the example we have, the first one on the right, on the slides, as you see, لَعَلَّكُمْ بِلِقَاءِ رَبِّكُمْ تُوقِنُونَ. لَعَلَّكُمْ بِ, how do I apply it in the first opinion? Yeah, لَعَلَّكُمْ بِ, there is a gap there. So they say your lips are like, there is a gap and they almost gonna close, but the gap stays there. There is a very little gap. Some ulama, such as Sheikh Ayman Rushdie Suwaid, says there is no origins for this opinion. Yes, and it's a weak opinion. And some try and differentiate it to the, some Allahu A'lam try and apply this rule to differentiate between a pure meme and an impure meme. Now the professional or the stronger opinion, Wallahu A'lam, is to what? Close your lips without pressure. So to differentiate between a pure and an impure meme, you say لَعَلَّكُمْ بِ. Now my lips are closed, but I feel like they're gonna open. The normal pure meme would be لَعَلَّكُمْ بِلِقَاءِ. And don't exaggerate now. Some people might think the pure meme is to say لَعَلَّكُمْ بِ. This is of course مبالغة وتكلف. This is exaggerating, yeah? We should not do this. So the pure meme will be لَعَلَّكُمْ بِ. The impure meme لَعَلَّكُمْ بِ. There is less pressure on my lips. And this, wallahu a'lam, is the, inshallah ta'ala, correct way of applying it. Of course, it's not a big يعني, we don't want to, of course, go and become the enemies of the others and stuff. لا. It's all, inshallah ta'ala, respected, even the other opinion. ولكن بعض العلماء say there is no origins for this, and بعض العلماء say the stronger opinion is to close your lips and do not pressure it. Even those that say that you keep a furja, they say that is the strong opinion. والله سبحانه وتعالى أجل وأعلى وأعلم. لكن إن شاء الله it is more accurate to close your lips, because when you open your lips, what are you saying? You can't, يعني, there is no letter that is being said. Now in the إخفاء and the إدغام of the نون ساكنة, in the إخفاء of the نون ساكنة, sorry, it's different. وهكذا كانت تتكلم العرب. Yes, the Arabs, when they used to speak, they speak like this. Now you will never hear an Arab say لعلكم بلي. Yeah, you will never hear this. A one that speaks Fusha, you say لعلكم بي. لعلكم بي. بلقائي. Of course, he's not going to be applying غنة. Yeah, and he's not going to be thinking of the pressure and هكذا. So if you say لعلكم, then there is a gap here that Allah أعلم about the strength of that opinion. But we mentioned what the ulama mentioned. This is not from me or my pocket or my father or anyone. جيد, it's from my teachers and what the ulama mentioned. جيد, any questions about this ruling, my brothers and sisters? Now you, maybe some of you are thinking, what's the difference between إخفاء شفوي and قلب? Did anyone think that? Or are you tired? Huh? Nope. Yep. جيد. So the difference is in one thing, which is what? In قلب, you are traveling from a noon to an entire different letter. In إخفاء شفوي, you are traveling from the same letter to the same letter, but taking some of its rights away. فقط. We don't want to fall into the فلسفة or talking too much and saying, no, the gap here is a bit more than لا. It's the same thing, except the travel is different. So when I say mim بعد, I changed the entire noon to a different letter. Whereas here, لَعَلَّكُمْ بِ So it doesn't, you wouldn't tell much difference here. صح? It's because the travel was shorter. I went from the same letter, from the letter meme to the letter meme, but I've taken a bit of it right away. Is that clear? Yes or no? Can you ever find إخفاء شفه within one word? No. جميل. Shall I move on? Good. ما شاء الله. الإدغام الشفوي. Also known as الإدغام المتماثل أو إدغام المثلين أو إدغام المتماثلين. I didn't write all of them down. You can write them down, inshallah ta'ala. And of course, I advise my brothers and sisters, when you study these rules, try, inshallah ta'ala, to read upon them. Read books on Tajweed. Read Al-Jazriya. I think, أخونا شيخ جمال, جزاه الله خير, you went through Al-Jazriya معهم, ولا لا؟ صح؟ جميل. So, these things, read the books of Sharh Al-Jazriya and تحفة الأطفال, but especially Al-Jazriya, and go even further. I think there's, inshallah ta'ala, a course that's going to be regular on Saturdays from now on. So, inshallah, try and join it. I forgot the details about it, but inshallah, you will receive an email or message about it. جيد. About the time and stuff. الإدغام الشفوي is when we merge the ميم ساكنة into the ميم متحركة that's after it. Yeah, so let's read from the slides. This rule is where we merge the ميم ساكنة into the ميم متحركة. What is ميم متحركة? What does متحركة mean, my brothers and sisters? It has a حركة. So it is a vowel ميم that appears after the ميم ساكنة. Yeah? Any letter in Arabic, you could say it is متحرك or what's the opposite of متحرك? ساكن. جزاك الله خيرا. جزاك الله خيرا يا أخي. So, it is a vowel ميم that appears after the ميم ساكنة. In this rule, of course. When we merge this ميم ساكنة into the next ميم متحركة, we must give غنة of which level? First. Third was when with regards to إخفاء شفوي. Here, when we merge into the next meme, we are what? Doing idgham what now? Is this idgham? Hands up. Or the sister can shout out. Or just shout out, inshallah, yeah? This idgham, is it idghamun kamil or idghamun naqis? When I merge into the next meme. So let's look at an example first. Look at the first example we have in the slide. أَنَّهُمْ مَبْعُوثُونَ أنهم Did you hear the sound of the meme? Did you hear غنة? Yes. This, so, did the existence of the first meme disappear or remain? And the غنة here? Did it disappear or is it here? The attribute, so the غنة of the first meme or the attribute of the first meme, is it gone or remained? Gone. So how comes I hear a meme? It's the second meme. How comes I hear the ghunna? It's the attribute for the second meme. Therefore, there is a shadda there. Always, idgham kamil. On the next letter, you'll find what? Shadda. That's just a hint. You, as professionals, shouldn't look for shaddas now. This shadda on a meme means it's of what level of ghunna? When I said to you, the first level of ghunna is when the noon or meme has a shadda. صح ولا لا? So it is of the first level of ghunna. So I will give it the most ghunna. Is that clear? Jameel. The rule of idgham shafawi can only happen between two separate words and can never occur or happen between what? Or within, sorry, one word. Yes? Al-idgham shafawi can never happen within one word and can only happen between two separate words. So we have an example here, and there is only one letter, of course, for the idgham shafawi, which is what? Mim. Is that here? Ha. Mim. And there is only one letter for ikhfa shafawi. What is it? Ha? Ba. Jameel. Are there any questions about ikhfa shafawi and idgham shafawi? So I'm going to read the second example. Alladhi at'amahum. وآمنهم من خوف أطعمهم من This is غنة of the first level and this is إدغام شفوي or إدغام مثلين أو متماثلين أو الإدغام المتماثل. Just remember it as شفوي for now. And آمنهم من same thing. Is that clear or not? Clear or not? Yes. Any questions, my brothers or sister and sisters? حبيبي, you tired, صح? I'm tired. جيد. The last rule of the rules of Mim Sakin, and forgive me, brothers and sisters, for speaking too much. Subhanallah, it's almost 10. Huh. Al-Idhar al-Shafawi is easy. This rule is where we will pronounce the Mim Sakina clearly if any of the Arabic letters appear after it, after the Mim Sakina, except for the letters what? Ba and Mim. This rule does not require any extra Ghunna and should be given the fourth level of Ghunna. Why? Because it's just a Mim Sakina. The rule of Idhar Shafawi can happen between two separate words or within one word. Unlike Ikhfa Shafawi and Idhar Shafawi. Is that clear? And the remaining letters of Arabic are all letters of Idhar Shafawi except for the letter Mim and Ba. Is that clear? And I've put a few examples here. One of them is of Idhar Shafawi within one word, and the other two is of Idhar Shafawi happening between two separate words. An'amta. This ghunna I've given was no extra effort. But do not rush and give qalqala on it. It has to have a minimum ghunna, and that is the fourth level of ghunna here. Same thing as in the second example. Rabbikum tuqinun. Rabbikum tuqinun. Did you hear the minimum ghunna there? Rabbikum tuqinun. Is that clear? And lastly, hum yura'un. Alladhina hum yura'un. Yeah, hum yura'un. Is that clear? Yes or no? Yeah? Jameel, I just have one more thing that I forgot actually to add to the slide. Alhamdulillah, we are humans and we always forget. But you can write that down as a note. And I will maybe add this note if you want to the slides, and then I could send it or resend it to the brothers and they can send it to you again. And this note is that you must put extra effort. But before writing, let's say it, and then I'll say, we'll say it in, inshallah, the shortest possible. There is extra effort required, or alertness, or you must be cautious when reciting a rule of Idhar Shafawi and you have the fa or the waw after the mim sakina. Why is this? Ahsanti ukhti. They share the same makhraj. And in the Jazriya, Imam al-Jazri says what? Wahdar lidha wawin wa fa an takhtafi. Wahdar lada wawin wa fa an takhtafi. لقربها والاتحاد فعرفي. So be careful when the mim sakina comes with a waw or fa after it. Why? Due to the closeness, or due to them sharing the same makhraj, the lips. And this is where you will find a lot of people falling into the mistakes of what? Doing idgham. They merge the mim sakina into the fa or waw. Yeah? So you must pay attention. Does that mean I give more ghunna? No, but you just need to pay more attention. Who wants to think of an example with me of idhar shafawi that occurs with a mim sakin and after it a fa or waw? Aha. Jayid, you can open the Quran if you want. يخادعون الله والذين آمنوا وما يخدعون إلا أنفسهم وما يشعرون. أنفسهم وما. A lot of people say أنفسهم وما. They do not pronounce the meme second clearly, especially with the letter fa, because it's easier to fall into the mistake of doing idgham. Like where a lot of people say نفس 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 يا نفس واتقوا يوما لا تجزي نفس نفس. This is not the giving the fa, it's right. You did not treat it like a loose letter, and neither did you fulfill the ruling or the attribute of hams. واتقوا يوما لا تجزي نفس عن نفس شيئا. But this is not what we an example, of course. I'm just giving an example of how it's easy to merge letters together if you do not give them their rights. That's an example of what ميم ساكنة after it واو إظهار شفوي. How I need to pay attention and make sure I do not merge it. Yes, أخي. Another example of واو. Say it, inshallah. غير المغضوب عليهم ولا غير المغضوب عليهم و. Yeah. جزاك الله خيرا أخي أبو بكر. One more example I want, but of the letter fa. Huh? Just recite anywhere you know and you'll find something, subhanAllah. يسارعون يسارع لهم في الخيرات. يسارع جزاك الله خير أختي. يسارع لهم في ال. A lot of people will fall into the mistake and say يسارع لهم في الخيرات. Did I say the meme? I think I did. Oh, I thought I did, but I did not. لهمف لهمف. This is what a lot of us fall into. لهم في ال. Make sure you give the fourth level of غنّة and then go to the fa, inshallah ta'ala. يسارع لهم في الخيرات. Is that clear, my brothers and sisters? Yes. So just note down, pay extra attention if the fa or waw come after ميم ساكنة. Due to what? The closeness or the same makhraj as the meme. That means that do not add extra ghunna, but just make sure you are giving the ghunna and applying it without merging into the fa or waw. You understand it now, I think, so you can put it in your own words. And if you study or learn or read the sharh of Al-Jazriya, it will mention it in there. Is that clear, my brothers and sisters? Any questions? Jayid. One second. So I just need to check. So Akhi Abu Bakr, you can take your paper inshallah. I'm not going to say the results in loud, huh? After. And we have Akhi Abdul Raqib. Is Abdul Raqib here? Jazakallah khair. So Abu Bakr and Abdul Raqib, if you want to help me, Yusuf, to give them the papers. Akhi Umar isn't here, صح? Is Umar here? No. So I'll keep his paper until he comes. Let me check. These are all the brothers done, yes. So these are the sisters, I just need to check something. If there is any mistake in the marks adding up, inshallah correct them, because I did them actually quite fast, inshallah ta'ala. So here are the sisters, inshallah, one of the sisters can make inshallah when they want and give them bi'idhnillah out, inshallah. Jazakallah khair. Jayid. This is us for today, inshallah ta'ala. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us. Any questions before we go, inshallah? Forgive me for keeping you late, it's 10 o'clock. Yes. Exam on sifat. Wallahi, that's up to the brothers and sisters, of course. If you want an exam on sifat, I can write you an exam on sifat. What do you think, brothers and sisters? Do you want a test or exam on sifat? Yes. Okay. Who wants? So from the brothers, 4 and 5. And from the sisters, khair, inshallah. So that's a good number. I think we will do it, inshallah ta'ala, soon. I know beforehand, bi'idhnillah. If there are some brothers and sisters that do not want to do it, which obviously there are some that don't want to do it, it's best I give you the paper, you time yourself, give yourself an hour when you go home, where you, of course, you have the amana to not, of course, go and copy it from the notes. You do the test, You bring it the week after, I take it, I mark it, and give you, inshallah, when I give you the papers back when I finish marking them, inshallah. Is that clear? جزاكم الله خيرا وبارك الله فيكم سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته
وبعد فالإنسان ليس يشرف إلا بما يحفظه ويعرف لذاك كان حامل القرآن أشرف لما أولي الإحسان وإنهم في الناس أهل الله